My name's Rob Snowhite. I am also known as the Fly Fishing Consultant. I quit corporate life 6 years ago as a federal consultant to pursue fly fishing full time. This is my real last name. I'm based out of Northern Virginia. I split my time between stay-at-home dad, between guiding, and I also work part-time at the Orvis Company Store in Tyson's Corner. And I tie flies for myself, for clients, as well as teaching a class for the Tidal Potomac Fly Rodders, which is our local Federation of Fly Fishers Club based out of the DC metro area. And I guide mostly on the Tidal Potomac and its tidal estuaries, in addition to some walk and wades inland and some inland lakes. And we fish for everything from largemouth, smallmouth, striped bass, snakeheads, carp, gar, tilapia, crucian carp, common carp, gar, blue catfish, channel catfish, various sunfishes, crappies. You don't know what you have until you land the fish because our water is discolored just because it's such an urban fishery. And you do have to watch out for shopping carts and office chairs, lawnmowers. It's interesting where we fish. Very interesting. Which is why this fly is tied in chartreuse. I can see it. And if it disappears, when I do see it, I can tell my clients to set the hook and fish. So this is the Snow White Damsel. It's super easy to tie. Basic ingredients. Start off with ostrich plume. I buy these here at the fly fishing show because I can tangibly have them in my hands. It's not something I want to order through Hairline because I want to look at them. I'm not too concerned about this far up. I want these long, wispy, kind of thick fibers. And the benefit of this, it's tough. Fish can't really destroy these. Second ingredient is bead chain. Home Depot, you get it in big strands. When you have free time, you can cut them up. And multicolor crystal flash. This is my preference. It's got a lot of hues to it. It lights up. And only three strands of this. And the last thing would be Saber brand hooks. I do work for a fly shop, but I use these because they're $7 for 100. They're ridiculously sharp. You can also buy them debarbed. It's a $100 copay for me to go to the hospital to have them debarbed. We fish only debarbed hooks, but I will buy barbed ones for clients. And then if I'm going to use another fly, say my scorpion bug, this will be barbed. So when I smash the barb down, there's still a nub in there that I can tie the monofilament to, and it won't slip off. You can't use a dropper fly with a barbless lead fly. And the weird thing is, you'll fish this rig, you'll get a bluegill on this, and you'll get like a 2 pound largemouth on the damsel. I use the tie wheel, sort of new on the market. It's a modular little device you can use, holds tools, but I fill this with beads, fill this with hooks, and this is how I do my assembly line. Three strands of crystal flash clamped down. And what I'll do is I'll cut these five strands, pull them through my mouth, wet them, and line them up. And I'll do that with 36 of them. And then I can sit down and do hook, bead, flash, ostrich plume, wrap it up, and I'm done. My thread preference is red 6-aught uni. And I don't know why. I don't think it matters. Red turns to gray underwater at a certain depth anyway, and my river is brown, so doesn't matter. I strictly use red, black, and chartreuse, unless I'm doing shad flies. It just keeps things simple. And I prefer the Regal Vice because I can grip it, open, put the fly in. With 3 pounds of wire, a base, and the tie wheel, I can lift the whole thing and move it. The Regal is just, it's too easy. It's simple. I have three of them. I use them for teaching classes. And we'll be teaching this for the shad run. The Tidal Potomac Fly Rodders. And I teach that free class once a month. And I'm buying all my hooks for the class for the year here today. And it's a simple fly. The biggest fish I caught on it is about a 4.5 foot gar. I've caught lizard fish in Hawaii. I have caught gizzard shad, American shad, hickory shad, white perch. I mean, and it doesn't matter how you fish it, it's that you just fish it. You can swing it, dead drift it, you can twitch it, let it sit on the bottom, below a dropper. It doesn't really matter how you fish it, it's always going to work. I think it's a lot that the tail just undulates, I've got damsel flies in my tank, and they don't move like that. They move like a cheetah stalking prey. You almost don't see them moving. It'll take them an hour to cross, you know, maybe that much of the tank. So I don't know if this to them looks like a damsel nymph swimming to the surface. That's what it looks wet, and it should rotate over. So I don't know what they see, but the first fish we caught on this were striped bass. Originally, it was the Orvis Living Damsel, and they stopped selling them. I couldn't recreate that, so I had to come up with my own. A lot of my flies are problem solving, where I can't get an ingredient or the fly's unavailable to me. There's two pictures online of a gutless frog. I don't know how to tie it, so I create my own. And that's why I tie flies, it's problem solving. And these are dirt cheap to tie, so you really crank out a lot. And it doesn't matter what species, everything we throw in the sat will eat it. I know Jim Teeny only fishes a teeny nymph. I could honestly only fish this fly and be confident that I could catch whatever I need to. And strictly chartreuse. The chartreuse color lets me see it from a distance when I'm guiding, whether sitting down on a boat or on shore. If I see this fly disappear, I'll yell set the hook. I'm gonna tie this rather slow because there's not a whole lot involved. I also wanna say it's a great trout fly. I talked all about the warm water species, but I'll use this on Tenkara down at the Rose River Farm in Virginia. And it cleans up. Rainbow trout out in Colorado too. So standard size 10 curved shrimp hook. Just gonna start my thread and I'm gonna add bead chain. I've used smaller bead chain, but I like this size. I don't know, it's the same as dog tags. Now I'm gonna add crystal flash, and I have it pre-measured out so I can tie and cut exactly what I need. I pre-measured and wet my ostrich plume, and now the Regal Vice has the knob here. That's how I measure it. Now I can count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3. And then it's gonna be 5 back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then I'm just gonna palmer this. And that is honestly the fly. I could go with something more technical, get those out of the way. But you know, you realize something as simple as, you know, grilled cheese and tomato soup, it's everyone's favorite lunch because it's simple. You don't have to have Chateaubriand and a Bordeaux every day. And I'm gonna whip finish with my finger or half hitch just because I'm a messy tire and I don't wanna have to put any tools down to pick up another tool. And I'll do it again, just a little slower. So that's the Snowhite Damsel.